bitch, turn the whole world into a savage middle. Love this hack. Okay, drape it over your neck, pull your arms through the straps, and then pull it over your head. And just like that, you have a backpack.
I'm a savage, classy, bougie, bitch, sassy, nice, hacking, stupid, what was happening, bitch, I'm a savage, yeah.
Won't you take me home, I wanna ride, and roll alone, ride, just lose control, ride, itch my soul, ride, it may feel you, ride, turn the lights down low, ride, from head to toe, ride, itch my soul.
Number one, trying to make you my numero uno.
Sharing my shoes stretching hack today. This will help your difficult pump to be a little bit more manageable. I'm using the blow dry on medium heat to stretch these Soul Kate from Christian Louboutin, since these seem to be the most difficult shoes for you guys. I applied the heat to all the corners and the back of my shoes. If you wear thicker socks, you might overstretch them. Make sure you let the shoe completely cool down before you try them back on. I apply lotion before putting the shoes back on. Hope this tip helped.
None of these videos actually show it on, so today we're gonna see if it's actually cute.
First, fold your scarf like this. Does not have to be perfect.
Put your bra on top and tie the two ends. And then wrap the rest of the fabric around the bra. Same for this side. Let's try it on.
It's so cute. I actually can't believe it works. The back is cute too.
Try it.
Take your shirt and you just get her in there.
Okay, I have to try. So I think you go like this and you flip it underneath. And then you fix it up a little bit and wait. Okay, you need to try this out with all of your tops right now. What?
Okay, so you know how these shirts are really popular right now? Well, I'm gonna teach you how to make one out of an old t-shirt. So if you wanna learn how, then just keep watching. Okay, so first just get a t-shirt that you wanna use, and I'm choosing this one because I like the color pink. Okay, so the first thing I did was cut off the bottom hem, then cut about halfway up the shirt, and I've already cut just to save time. Okay, so now that everything's cut, it should look like this, and now we're gonna put it on. Okay, now you should have something that looks like this, and all we're gonna do is twist it like this, and put it through your head. Okay, then it should look like this. And now you have a cool new shirt that didn't cost anything to make, and you recycled old clothing.
Okay, so you want to know 3 ways to wear booby tape. Let's do this. I'm using the brand new. She comes in different skin tones and we love an inclusive queen. I'm wearing a tank top for demonstration purposes. For dress number 1, we're going to do the crossover style, bringing the tape underneath in an X formation. It's going to definitely lift the girls. For a peekaboo cutout dress, you're going to do the bandeau style, nice and simple. And for a more revealing style, you're going to just do the pasty. Use more or less tape if you need it. Thanks for watching. Like for part 2.
I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love?
I tell you everything.
I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want. Go get it. You get what you please. We bout to get it on.
You can call me when you want, call me when you need, call me in the morning, I'll be on the way, call me when you want, call me when.
Girls, let's talk camel toe. I love leggings, but I don't like how they bunch up in your crotch area because it's really uncomfortable and it just doesn't look good. So I challenged myself to design the anti-camel toe legging. The reason why you get camel toe physically is because your gusset just simply isn't strong enough. So a gusset is a piece of fabric inserted into the seam to reduce stress from tight-fitting clothing. This is the typical triangle gusset you'll find on most yoga pants, but it's just not strong enough, therefore giving you camel toe. In my quest to design the anti-camel toe pant, I was going to make a very strong gusset. So this one goes all the way from knee to knee, pulling that excess fabric away from your crotch and into your inner thighs. So this is what the pant looks like as I pull up. As you can see, no camel toe because there's a lot of tension pulling away from your crotch. I think it turned out pretty nice. What do you think?
Keep pushing until you get to the other side and then pull it through until the sock.
Okay, this I gotta try. Okay, I was momentarily sad because I have one of these patch things, but then I realized you can just cut 2 holes next to it. Pulling her through. I'm gonna do 1 more pair. So it's just like a little baggy, but oh yeah, that's like way better.
And this is where you're gonna put your head.
Okay, so you guys know I have to try this. So it's the same thing as last time. So you just flip it underneath like this, but instead of putting it on like this, you just go like this, and then you put this one on this side. Hold on. I'll show you without the gray shirt. Okay, try this with all of your tops. I actually can't believe it. And this is what the back looks like. Everyone wanted to know. It's literally the same as the front. Try it.
Must-have pants for short girls. First one is skinny jeans, shows off your curves, and you need mid-rise because low-rise is no good for you. A common misconception, petite girls should not wear wide legs. If they go over your ankles, you will be okay. And the last one are chino pants with some sort of darts or folding. And again, they need to go over your ankles.